Hey there, guys and gals, Rob here with Deluks Gaming, and welcome to The Last Leviathan. This is a early access game. As a matter of fact, it was released on June 22nd of 2016, so a couple weeks ago, and it is being developed by Superpunk Games. What a great name for a developer, by the way. Superpunk Games. Who do you work for? Superpunk. I just love it. I'm sorry. I think that's a great name for a developer. So what is The Last Leviathan? The Last Leviathan is a physics-based voxel ship simulator where you can build your ships from keel to sail using a block-by-block format, just like a lot of these games. Not totally unlike From the Depths, but it's a little bit easier to manage. Not to say that it has nearly the detail as From the Depths, but the engine is smooth, it's clean, it's nice, you can control your ships. I actually really, really like it. Now, the game is certainly unfinished. It is very much early access. There is no campaign mode yet, but there is a number of challenges that you can jump into right now, and that's what we're gonna do today, and possibly for about 5 episodes. We'll just see how it goes. There may not even be enough content to do more than five episodes of this, but I'm gonna promise at least 5 episodes, because I am pretty sure that we can have a lot of fun even in 5 episodes. So let's get going. Let's get started right away. Looking at what's available to us right now, we're gonna start at the top. We've got Voyage Mode, which is, I believe it's going to be the campaign mode of the game, which is not quite yet available, where you get to build, sail, navigate, and fight across the seas, unveiling the secrets of Minhir in a voyage of survival and discovery. It sounds very Norse, right? And I've also heard that there's going to be sea monsters, like release the Kraken kind of sea monsters. Like, oh, that's so exciting. Can you imagine, you know, captaining a ship against like a giant squiddy Kraken-y type thing? Oh, that'd be so cool. So I'm pretty sure that's going to be in there as well. Then we've got a creative mode, which is basically you build your ships and you upload it to the workshop. Pretty straightforward. And then you've got the battle seas, which is what we're going to be doing today. We'll come back to that. Then you've got versus mode, where you get to download stuff from the workshop and then pit it against each other. And you do get to actually captain your ships in this game. It's not all automated fighting, which is kind of cool. Then we've got the events. This is interesting. I'm actually, you know, let's just read this. So there's different events that are going to be available at different times. So right now they have a YouTube event. So listen to this, the Iron Blast Challenge. Pit yourself against the terrifying Iron Blast ship. All you need to do is beat it in a battle with 2 stars. Don't know what the stars mean yet. Or more in the quickest time possible and video yourself doing it. So I might jump in on this. I don't know. I don't think I'm qualified to jump in on this quite yet. So second place, you can win a silver star in the Last Leviathan Challenge of Hall of Legends. First place, you can win a t-shirt and a gold star. Third place, you can win a bronze star. The t-shirts are actually kind of attractive. I do like the black one. That's really nice. And I love the design. Actually, it's really cool. But so I'd have to, start date was the 6th of July. End date is the July 25th. I might jump in on this, but right now I have basically almost no experience with this game whatsoever. So just interesting. They have events already. That's kind of cool. And then there is the options menu, which terrifies me. All it has here is this ominous slider labeled physics joint CPU allocation. Do not touch. Sorry, that's, to me, that screams do not touch. Slider low and high. I'm not going near that thing with the 10-foot pole. Super funny. So today we're going to be doing Battle Seas. So Battle Seas organizes challenges and events into ship classes. Earn stars to progress to the next level. Available now, a series of pirate battles of increasing difficulty. So, and coming soon is racing events, dock sieges, survival battles, and much more. Maybe even monster battles in here too as well. So I have played with this, just so that everybody knows. Now as far as I know, I'm trying to understand totally how this works, but you build a ship, and with each class has a limited amount of power that you can use to build a ship, and then you take that ship and you fight pirates of the same class, and depending on how many stars a ship is worth, you get that many stars when you destroy it. So I destroyed 4 small pirate ships already with the basic class of ship that I built. And we need 11 stars to make it to the Hulk class, which is a different size level. So, or different power level, a higher power level. So, yeah, let's go in here. I'm going to show you what I've done. I built a very basic ship. I don't know, it wasn't terrible. I mean, for my first ship, it wasn't terrible. So, this is it. This is the... I called it first. I don't know. In honor of YouTube, I called it first. So basically, it had the claw in the front, and it had a couple of really big cannons. And this one's like a little rotating, you know, almost like a machine gun cannon, which is really cool. And then you've got these big cannons. Like, these are kind of a larger cannon, I believe. Maybe I don't even know. I'd have to go look. But and then of course, here's the thing. I didn't know any better at the time, but I left my little steering wheel here, and I think I built the ship backwards because it steers backwards. So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We're going to rebuild. We're going to build a brand new ship here anyway. And then we're going to go over all of the options that are available. No, that ship is badass. Upload it to the workshop. Sure. No, I'm not going to upload this to the workshop. Create new ship. Yes. Okay, so we're going to start over here. So let's go over the options. So what's really nice about this is that all of the building blocks are at the bottom of the screen. Now, as time goes on and they start to get, you know, 150 different building blocks, are they going to be able to have them all down here? I don't know. Maybe they'll have a whole list of them, you know, have hull weapon, have hull one, hull two, hull three. I don't know. I have no idea how they're going to do this, or they're going to have just keel stuff or just decking, or maybe they do a drop down menu or something. But I really like having it all available right in front of me, and this size too. I can see it really well. I am playing this in 1440p, but everything is, it's nicely sized. What's funny about this actually is the reason it's taken me so long to actually start doing a feature on this game itself is because when I started this game 2 weeks ago in 1440p, everything was upside down. So there was a big bug causing this and everything else to be upside down. As a matter of fact, all the islands, everything was upside down. I actually had to flip around entirely in order to play, and it just didn't work. So anyway, that's why it took me so long to start playing this game. But anyway, so you've got, here's the thing. We are supposed to make a cog ship, which means a ship that not exceeding 2500 power, and every block in the game has a certain power level, so a certain power number attached to it. So for example, this rotting wooden block has a power of 10, whereas this barrel of rum has a power of 30, and they have some other attributes too, and they might even have some hidden attributes that I'm unaware of, because here's the thing. So we've got the rough wooden block, which is a power of 30, but it has a weight of 200, so it's fairly heavy and a health of 400. Why wouldn't I use the barrel of rum over that, which gives us a power of 30, but only weighs 150? I don't know. And maybe it's because the barrel of rum can't be attached to everything, but you see, if we go like this, I think we can make an entire ship out of barrels of rum if we wanted to. I think that's what we're going to do, guys. We're going to make an entire ship out of barrels of rum. Why? Because we can. Whoops. Controls. So yeah, here, the controls, we'll go over this really quickly. So rotate blocks, Q and E. There needs to be a rotate block forward and back too as well, because I don't think Q and E is enough. That just rotates it from side to side. That's not enough. Place block, left mouse button. Pretty straightforward. Delete block. All you got to do is hold down the control button and hit the left mouse button at the same time. Copy block, control, and middle mouse button. That way we can pick up blocks, which is great. And move the ship around. So yeah, using the cursor keys, page up, page down. And reset camera focus. So is C. So if we go back and we go C, it'll bring us. So if I get all screwed up here, so if we zoom right out and we turn. No. Yeah, there we go. C brings us right back in, which is kind of handy. And then, of course, we can. So if we built this ballast here and we put this right here, and then I can go left. Hold on. Control down, control, and go left mouse button. And then I should have the barrel attached to me again. There we go. Just like that. Pretty straightforward. Very easy to use. And then control, and then left mouse button, and that deletes the block. Very, very easy to use. Very simple. I don't know. I find that the build mode in this is really quite, I don't know, it's childproof. it's me proof. If I can use it, anybody can use it. So you'll notice So where your cursor is before you place a block determines which direction the block is going to be, which is good and bad. Now, as far as rotating goes, if I use the Q and E button, it just rotates it like that. Q and E button just rotates it like that. So in other words, I couldn't place the block. So if I wanted to place it upwards like this, except on the side, what I have to do, which is really wonky, I have to, I have to go, I don't even know if I can do it, to be honest with you. I might not be able to. Yeah, so I'd have to do that and then delete these blocks. See, isn't that wonky? It's wonky. So there needs to be another option aside from Q&E. There needs to be like, I don't know, R and F or something, so you can push it forward and push it back. But whatever, it doesn't matter. We're going to build this ship out of barrels of rum because it's got a medium amount of power, but it's got a health of 400, which is great. Now, there may be a reason why I wouldn't want to use barrels of rum. Maybe it explodes. Maybe the rum explodes. I don't know. But I'm going to do things a little differently this time. Last time, I didn't protect my little steering wheel here. Or my I forget what it's called. It's a steering wheel, right? I don't know. My ship speech, like, I know port and starboard, but I know keel. I know what a keel's for, and I know some basic stuff, but, I might be wrong in some of my terminology. Please don't attack me. Oh, hey, that worked. I guess I could place those like that. Okay, perfect. So that's good. I'm just going to... Now, these, like I said, these may explode. I don't know. So now that we've done that, I think we're going to use some regular... regular old rotting double wooden cubes. So these are just a fast way to build your ship a little bit bigger. And I want the front end to be on this side. So we're going to go across like this. Maybe we'll add a little bit of flavor, add it, maybe do it a little bit wider so that we can have some nice guns on the side there too as well. And I was thinking this time I want to use some decking too. I'm not quite sure how to use this decking though, because thing is, how do you place it flat? I don't know how to place the decking flat unless you, I don't know. So when you can rotate it like that, but how do you place it flat on the, maybe it's not meant to be like that. I don't know. I have no idea. I know. Like I said, we're just messing around right now. I mean, I'm going to play this mission. We're going to play our first mission, but don't expect anything great here right now. Well, like, I'm still learning the game. So I think we're going to do these all the way across there. These all the way across there. Like I said, this is not going to be a huge ship. It's going to be a boat. This is going to be a boat. It's not going to be a ship. And then we'll get some more of these. I'm just using the lowest power stuff. See, we've already used 1,000 power. The ship, the boat can't be that big, because if we make it too big, we're not going to have enough points to put on weapons and stuff. So there's also armor, there's decking, there's keel. Of course, the keel is to keep your ship upright, right? Because it's just the heavy point of the ship to keep your ship upright. Then armor and cladding, so you can have shield armor. So yeah, kind of like the Vikings would do. They would have the shields across the side of the boat. Is that ever cool? That looks really neat. But that uses a ton of power. Each one of those is 100 power. Wow, there's a 50 power version. Whoops. Hold on. Control like that. And then I like the design. The design so far was pretty good, but I don't know. It's pretty basic. Everything's pretty basic here right now. So let's get this out of the way. And actually, let's grab another one of these and finish off the back end here. Actually, no, let's go through it all. So we've got decking. We've got armor. Then we've got lights. Mounted brazier. I don't know. I've never used this thing before. Power of 16. I don't know why. Why something like this would give us power unless it actually, you know, it causes fear or something. Oh, I see. Hold on. Let's delete this. It's like a headlight. That's kind of cool, actually. I like it. So let's put our headlight right there. Totally useless. I don't think it's going to help us at all. Scopes. Now, I don't know. Does the scope help us? I have no idea if the scope... Maybe we can use the scope. We can actually use the scope to find the bad guys. I don't know. I have no idea. And then we've got figureheads. I don't know, just for fun. But it gives you power of 100. So maybe it does... Maybe it instills fear in the enemies when they... Maybe the more powerful your ship is, the more fearful the enemy is, too, as well. So a bulk figurehead, power of 100. Let's just take a quick look at it. Wow, is that ever cool? Oh, my God. What is it? It's like a... I don't know, whatever it is, it looks pretty cool. Oh man, that looks great. It's like a minotaur or something. That looks really awesome. Then you've got, what is these called? Balustrade corner, balustrade end curl. These are all things I haven't used. It looks like more decoration? I'm not even sure. I'm sure you guys will let me know anyway. So power 5, they don't give you a lot of power, but decoration. Yeah, strictly decoration. It says decoration right there. And then, of course, you've got the rest of your hull points. There's all just varying different varying levels of power. So you've got the rotting version, the rough double version, and the planed version. So same with the small single blocks. You've got the rough, the rotting, the rough, and the planed. And same with the edges, and then the wedges, and then the different types of wedges too as well. Just three different versions of the same thing. Then you have a ballast, so that would just be a heavy block to ballast your ship to balance it out so it doesn't, you know, tip one way or another, I guess. I don't know. So anyway, let's finish this off. Well, we could do maybe the wedge. I don't know. Let's see here. Thing is, you gotta kind of have it. I don't know if we, the wedges. I don't know. It seems tricky to put these in, but I don't know. See, like, how do you get it facing the right direction? It's weird. I guess you know what. Well, what I think I'm gonna do is to keep things simple for this episode, because, yeah. So I think if we did this and we did this, we should be able to put a wedge on the in-between. Now, I may have to actually attach it to one of these. It's kind of tricky to get them in the right direction. There we go. Like that. Yeah, that works. Ha ha ha. Victory. I love games like this. I wish I had played more from the depths. I just haven't at this point, and I know I should, because I know how good it is. I played a little bit of it. It takes so much time to get into it, and I find the build mode in this is very easy. Like, because everything's laid out right in front of you, whereas from the depths, it's kind of buried unless you know all the keyboard commands and stuff, and it just takes time to learn it, and it's... Time is one thing I don't have a lot of, generally speaking, so I guess we're just going to use this part like that. Okay, perfect. And I think last time we had to, like that, I think. Yeah, like so, perfect. So the only way I can think of to place decking flat, so you can place decking flat like that, but the only other way I can think of to place decking would be to... remove this. They need to change it so that, because right now it seems a little wonky that you can't place, you know, there. Now you can place decking like that. That's weird. So you can't place decking on top of blocks. That's what it's saying. Okay. So it's in place of, like, hull parts like that. Now, what is the difference in power here? So it's only power 5 versus that 2 block, which is power 10. Oh no, the 2-block is actually, the 2-block rotting double wooden cube is 18, so it's actually cheaper to put the decking on. And really, do we need that much defense, you know, in these points right here? Probably not, so let's remove this. I know, it's totally pointless because, I don't know if it's pointless or not, actually. This might be useful. So, let's remove this one, and let's place a block here, let's middle mouse button this guy, and then put that guy... Hello. And in the future, you know, if we get into this game, if we start playing this game and, you know, get a little bit more serious about it, I will definitely be doing fast forwards for this, because, you know, I don't want to torture you guys with this kind of build every time, you know, like, because it would drive everybody crazy, including myself. If, you know, just having, you know, 2 hours of building and then, you know, 10 minutes of fighting, you know, it doesn't make any sense. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Let's... I know, it doesn't make any sense, does it? But basically, I wanted the design to be, you know, armor heavy in the front, and I don't care as much in the back, but as long as our little steering wheel is protected, we could even do like, whatever, it doesn't matter. Okay, so let's put a little bit of armor on this. So we're going to put a little bit of armor up in the front here to protect it. So this is the fish scale armor. Each one is power 75. It's pretty hefty. But we don't want to lose our rum barrels that are protecting our little steering wheel there. If we lose our steering wheel, we lose, like, it's done. Now, let's look at weapons. So, yes, so now, oh, also we have to look at movement, too. We may not have enough power to actually put this thing together. So, okay, so I didn't take that into consideration when I was putting this together. So we actually need to delete this, and we're going to put some props. Some tiny props. Each of these props is power 300. You know what? We're going to use one prop. Because, wow, that's super expensive. And we also need a rudder. Do we need a really good rudder? I don't know. Let's do this rudder here. I don't know if it's good or not. That's the medium rudder. That's power 150. Now, let's do the small rudder. That's power 50. It's probably not good enough, but whatever. I hope... Is the rudder going the right way? I have no idea. I have no idea if the rudder's going the right way. Okay, so let's let's throw that on. We'll see what happens. That looks right. Maybe, but I don't think it's supposed to be sticking out like that. There we go, like that. I don't know, I guess we're going to find out. Now, like I said, I have played this game a little bit, but I just threw stuff on. I didn't care because I just wanted to see if the engine was working. And I didn't really care about what the ship looked like or, you know, anything else beyond that. So, I kind of like having, you know, that kind of sitting like that too as well. I don't know, that looks kind of cool. Protect the barrels from the backside. I like that. Can I place this somehow in here? Oh, that's kind of cool, too. I like that as well. That's neat. Okay, but I'm spending too much money. Yeah, see, this is supposed to be a very small ship, so we need to get to weapons here. So, movement. What else do we have in movement? So, we've got rudders and sails. Yes, you can actually attach sails to your ship. Sails, of course, are just an alternative way of powering your ship, of making it move forward, aside from using a rudder, or aside from using a prop. Now, it is cheaper. So, a basic propeller is 300, whereas the smallest sail... Sail with boom is power 110. So, I don't know, we could, instead of using the rudder, we could add a sail. That'd be kind of fun. Let's do that. Let's delete the rudder. Or not the rudder, the the propeller. Let's delete the propeller and let's add a sail. Let's remove this and let's add a sail. Right, can I just, I don't know. I have no idea how sails work. This could be a total fail. And I would think that the sail would need to be more centralized. So hold on, let's put the sail. Can we put it right in there? No. Okay, I'm going to remove the headlight, and we're going to put the sail there. Yeah, because the sail should be at the front of the ship. Not that there's much difference between the front and the back of the ship. And that gives us a little bit more power. I guess we won't use the headlight for now. I just want to win this one. So let's go to weapons. Ah, yes, there's so many good weapons. So we've got triple mini cannons and three different variations thereof. But even the smallest one is power 100. The largest one is power 500. Ooh, and they're mini cannonballs. Damage 175, 125, and 75, so respectively. So, and then you've got the deck cannons. So those are the ones, yeah, these are the big deck cannons. Now, even the smallest deck cannon does damage 150, but they're harder to aim. And these are faster firing, these triple mini cannons. These triple mini cannons are actually really good. Then you've got the fire cannon, which is a flaming cannonball. Oh my god, that sounds so much fun. Okay, I'm gonna throw one of these on. I don't know, maybe we'll kind of Frankenstein this. Oh, I can't put it on the side? Oh, it's not gonna let me put it on the side. Oh, I have to put it back. Oh, I see. Okay, let's put one right in front. That looks, oh my god, that looks fun. It doesn't look safe. Like, why would I put something that's on fire on my ship? But, you know, this thing, like, this is rotted wood. I don't know, this thing would go up really fast. And then you've got mortars. Now, mortars, of course, aren't direct fire weapons. They can actually sit in behind like this. Oh, but you don't want it going through your sail, though. So maybe let's delete that. I don't know if that would matter or not. I really don't know. So maybe, I don't know, we'll put... So these mortars are 200 power each. Oh, they're pretty expensive. Let's see what else we got. Then we've got... We can ram. We can design the ship for ramming, too, as well. You know, the Vlad the Impaler. Look at this. Oh, my God. That looks awesome. But we don't have the power to do that. These are worth 300 apiece. Or we've got the big blade things. Oh, these look good. Steel blade left. Oh, my God. That looks awesome. Oh, cool. That looks so cool. And basically just sideswipe ships and cut them in half. Whoops, I just deleted something. Didn't mean to delete what I deleted. So let's put that back here. Let's go control like so. Awesome. And then I need to fix the front of the ship too. It doesn't look right, does it? It's too blocky. So we'll do that in a second. Let's go back to weapons here. I just want to see what kind of weapons we need. You know, you almost have to start with weapons because each weapon uses a lot more power than your basic stuff. Then we've got basic flamethrowers. That's not a bad idea. We could do one side as kind of a flamethrower kind of thing. You know, we could... So as we're passing by, we hit them with the flamethrower. That's kind of cool. I like that idea. So, yeah, just to try it, sure. But before I go any further, let's fix our ship. There we go. Isn't it great? I don't know. Maybe it is. Maybe it isn't. I don't even know at this point, but I made some, I did it. I added a whole bunch of, you know, special looking stuff to make it look really cool. And then I realized I need more guns like this thing. So I've got the two little mini cannons here, the triple mini cannons, which are damage 75 each, but they're really easy to aim. They're fast firing. And then I've never used these guns before. I mean, I've hardly used anything in this game before. I've only played once. And then I've got these things, which are the fire cannon. So we've got lots of firepower here. I think we've got four main cannons. And these fiery cannons, they are damage 150, but they're way slower than the other ones. So yeah, that looks pretty cool. And I had enough room left for a light in the back, the fiery light. And then of course we've got I even had enough for this funny little decoration on the top. So I like it. I like it a lot. I hope it'll actually float. I have no idea. It might just sink. I didn't add a keel or anything. And I don't know. We still have that one little rudder and we only have the little sail. I have no idea. Let's save this. What are we going to name this? My ship's name is the Fiery. Hold on. Caps lock. Fiery Spitballer. So it's an angry small ship. Hold on, spit balliber, baller. There we go, fiery spitballer, perfect, excellent. It's better than the first one. Look at this. It's so much better. It's hand hands down better. All right, there we go. So back. I mean, it looks better anyway. May not actually float. It might just sink. Okay, how do we go? Set sail. Here we go. Uh-oh. Okay. Whew. I got worried there for a second. Ah, the sail is working. Okay, so pretty... Uh-oh. We're a little front heavy. Yeah, little front heavy. Uh-oh. We may actually need to... I don't know. Uh-oh. We've been spotted by a pirate ship. Right there. Oh, is that him? Okay, so there's a couple ways you can control your guns. You can double click to do like, this is not going to work. Because our guns are underwater half the time. That's not good. Okay, so what we're going to have to add a keel maybe? I don't know. We got to add something to give it more weight in the back. All right, let's go back. Let's go dock. Oh, I can't. Do I have to keep fighting? Okay, well, I guess we'll use our rear guns. Hold on. Ah, here we go. I think we've got a turn here now. Turn. We're turning the wrong way, so the rudder is backwards again. Perfect. Uh-oh. Let's see here. Okay, what are we facing anyway? He's a pretty simple ship. Pretty simple. Let's get in there. Fire away. Now we can fire all guns at once. How do we do that again? Fire blank, go back, fire single. I don't remember how to fire everything. So, there we go. We can fire everything with the space bar. Fire! Oh, yes. Couple good hits and this guy will go down. Like, he's not going to last very long, I don't think. Oh, can't see what I'm doing, though, in that mode. So let's maybe... Fire! Fire! So we can... Oh, he's actually on fire. That's fantastic. He tried to ram me or something. Are we on fire? Yep, we are on fire. All of the rum barrels were a bad choice. They were a bad choice, but he's going down. Look at him. Oh yeah, we're so on fire. Building a ship out of rum barrels was a bad choice. Who knew? I think the engine is great. It's really fun to play with. We just need to destroy this little... I'm surprised. How can he not be sinking? Like, I wonder how long it takes before ships start to sink when they're on fire like that. Like, I'm sure they do start to sink, but wow. He's holding me up, actually. It's great. So I'm able to use all of my guns all at the same time. I love it. It's actually really great. But yeah, I think our ship is too short. We need to make it longer and have more ballast in the back so that... what is he trying to do? I don't... Whoa! There we go. Ooh, we got 2 stars for that. Okay, so propellers only work if they're underwater. Yeah, okay, got it. And guns only work if they're not in the water. All right, let's go back to the dock. I'm going to make a quick adjustment, and I'll be right back. All right, see you in a second. What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? Okay, there. I mean, all I did was add a keel and I removed some of the side blocks. I don't know. It looks kind of wonky and I don't know. I mean, it said that we can use it says that you can use the keel on the back, but I mean, I'm just looking for weight. I suppose we could have added ballast in the back or something. The problem is the ship is too short, right? So we just want to make sure that the back end keeps the front guns, you know, facing out of the water, really. So let's go. Let's set sail. Yay! Let's see, did it work? Oh, might have worked too well. No, actually worked great. Look at that. See, you guys all said I was crazy. You all said I was crazy, but I'm not as crazy as you think. we could have shot the boy. Ah, let's shoot the boy. Oh no, we can't shoot the boy. We can't turn worth a damn. Actually the sail, we need to go where the sail's going. So, is there bad guys? I don't see any bad guys yet. We still need to kill at least, well, there he is. We still need to keel. We need to keel at least one more pirate. Okay, turn the ship around. We're going to turn the ship around, guys. Now, he looks interesting, doesn't he? Now, I never took that spotting scope. Oh, man, I should have taken that because I bet you we can use that to spot, too, as well. Now, can we use this? We can't use this light or anything, so. All right, let's go. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey, up she rises. Her light in the morning. Oh. I've been spotted by the pirate ship, so now he's going to come in and attack me, which is great, because otherwise, it's going to take us forever to get to him. So, shall we try to do this in combat mode again, like in the first person? I like the first person. It's kind of fun. So, here we go. Woohoo! Oh, we should have taken mortars. Mortars would have been great. So, I don't know if we can hit from this range, but I'm going to give it a shot anyway. We are definitely shooting underwater sometimes. Fire everything! Yes, fire! Uh-oh, ow. Fire everything! Fire it all, fire everything! Okay, so it's probably better if we go into not first person mode because... Oh, here we go. Fire everything! Fire everything, guys! Uh-oh, he's using those same kinds of guns. Uh-oh. And he's about to ram us with that big old... Oh, the big old spike! Oh, no! Oh, that does some damage. Wow, he just... Holy crap! Holy crap, all of our rum's on... Not the rum! Not the rum! Save the rum, guys! Oh, no! Oh, no, he's... I can't move. Like, there's an advantage to... Oh, we don't have a sail anymore. Okay, so... Uh-oh. Well, we can shoot aimlessly. No, we can't. We can't even shoot aimlessly. It's not even gonna let us. There's nothing we can do. We can't move. We only had the one sail. That was it. That was it for our movement. So he has a propeller. Look at him. Oh, no. Oh, no. The fiery spitballer is going down. It's actually, I think, what, building your ship out of rum barrels is a bad choice. Who knew? Who knew? Oh, the Kraken wakes. Did it? It just said the Kraken wakes. Uh-oh. Is there a Kraken underneath us? Oh, my God. Now, I know monsters are coming. I don't know when, but I know they're coming. I'm just trying to see if we can see anything underneath the water. I don't think so. Yeah, there's nothing I can do. It's pretty much over. We're just waiting for him to kill us. Can I still turn? I can still turn, which is weird. So, and it looks like, maybe you always move at one knot. I don't know. But yeah, use your telescope to find the next target on the horizon, especially in foggy weather. It's funny. It's telling me that now. This is useless information to me. Do not come to me with anything other than, Captain, I have a way to turn our guns. And now, hey, is that possible? Can we turn our guns, maybe? I don't think these are designed to be turned. No. So we can shoot forward. No. Now, I think in the future, we might actually build, weapons so that we can fire laterally. So, yeah, like, originally, our design, what I was thinking is we would have flamethrowers on the side to shoot the bad guy. But anyway, guys, I gotta call this. If you like this type of video, if you like The Last Leviathan and want to see more, let me know in the comments below. Leave a like. If you hate it and you never wanted to see it again, it makes you angry and mad and it makes you want to stamp your feet because something exists that isn't perfect, that you don't like 100%, or it's too much like From the Depths, but it's not From the Depths and it makes you mad or whatever, then leave a dislike. But if you like it and want to see more, leave a like. And that's how I'll determine whether or not we do more than 5 episodes of this or maybe do more in the future. But I'm going to guarantee probably 5 episodes of this, and we're going to do better in our ship builds. Live and learn. Okay, guys, we will talk to you soon. Take care.